Columbus Grove, Ohio. Holy cow, I had to think of the name of this town. Delivered this morning up in Michigan, southern Michigan, Van Buren Township. Did a Costco DC up there. I didn't really get any video of that load. It was kind of boring. Picked up some Bush's baked beans in Wisconsin and brought them to Michigan. Now we're, then I drove down here into Ohio, stopped at a Love's, and I've been looking for loads most of the morning. It's 1:30 in the afternoon now, and this one popped up about 30 minutes ago. It's just a quick run. It's going from where I'm picking it up to Rossford, Ohio, and then I'm dropping off in Rossford and picking up some more stuff from the same spot and bringing it right back here. I honestly think that it's about 160 miles total round trip, maybe a little less. Actually, I think it's about 80 miles round trip. So, can't do math right, but that's what we're doing right now. We're headed over there. We're about 20 minutes away on a nice Northwest Ohio back little highway here. But pretty good little load to end the week on here. I left home Sunday. It's Friday. So we're going to get up here, and I will talk to you guys when we get there. It looks like this is it up here on the right. This is a much bigger place than I thought I was coming to. A lot bigger place than I thought I'd be coming to. All these little towns here in Northwest Ohio, they all have some sort of factory in them. At least one, usually more than that. It's kind of what runs these towns. It's cool. But this is quite a bit bigger than I thought.
Turn right on Progressive Drive, then keep right.
God, I rolled my ankle the other day, well, yesterday morning. Ugh, it is sore. He has stopped back a little ways. Thank you very much, young lady. Thank you. You have been taught well.
Keep right to Sugar Grove Lane.
Let's get on up and jump. See what we got. Man, look at this nice green grass. Man, I love it out here. What do you think, Apollo, huh? What do you think? We are going to get some cars.
In 1/4 mile, arrive at 200 Sugar Grove Lane on the right.
Okay. There might be tricky with those trailers. Let's go down to the next one. Well, we could have made that, but they almost have that set up like that's not how they want it. And I want to see this sign, because that's definitely a good boy. Let's see. Steel receiving.
Arriving at 200 Sugar Grove Lane on the right.
Shipping and receiving this way, huh? Okay. Here we go. Shipping and receiving. Here we go. I'm going to pull up behind this guy. Going to get checked in and see what is what. Nobody, you stay here. Yeah, you stay here. I gotta go get checked in, and then got loaded very quickly there, and at 2 out of 2:30, we are hauling parts for the new absolutely hideous Ford Broncos up to a place to get painted, and we are picking up parts that have already been painted and bringing them back. So that's pretty cool. I honestly heard about the Broncos first on a podcast. I had never really seen a photo or anything of them until they came out. They are atrocious. I hate them. I think that they are honestly a disgrace to the Bronco name. I like Chevy K5 Blazers. I think the new Blazers are the same thing. If you're going to make a Bronco in an old square body, or at least halfway, and make them big. Not some ugly little SUV that I hate them. They're terrible. I would never own one. There's just no. God awful. That's what they are. And it's crazy to me because people order them. They've ordered them. They're years out. They're ugly. They're horrible. Why would you want one? Oh, well. I'm not buying one, so I guess I don't have to worry about it. Not my problem. So, yeah. This should be, I hope when I get up here, this is a quick turn and burn, just like it was getting loaded. I mean, I was there in total about a half hour. So, I mean, it's been really nice. So I just got to get up here, get unloaded, get the painted stuff, go back, and then we're going to call it a day. It's a gorgeous day, too. That's what we're doing right now, so I'll talk to you guys when we get up there. We're about 20 minutes away. So. we started this quick little run. Got up to the delivery, got in and out really quick. Empty on one side of the building, loaded on the other, paperwork, and away we go. 30 minutes, that's how long I was there. So, for once, the longest part of this load's probably gonna be the driving, which doesn't happen a whole lot. On short runs, usually you're stuck waiting in a shipper or receiver for half a day, so this has been really nice. We're only 8 miles away from bringing these painted Bronco parts back to the factory. And then calling it a day. I'd find somewhere to go to park after that. Not 100% sure what's close. I know the Loves that I came from. This is ridiculous. Really not a good road to go on a bicycle ride on. The Loves that I came from is kind of a ways away. I don't really want to go back there. So we'll take a look here in a couple minutes once we get back into the dock and see where we're going to go for the night. Pandora sounds like a sci-fi movie town, or post-apocalyptic town or something. Pandora. Small town America. I love it. I miss it. Never thought I'd say that. Forward to after this load, I got to do a reset, so I'm really looking forward to next week. I hope hoping to get some more really good loads like we've had. The last three have been stellar. The one out of Denver sucked, it always does, but the last three have been stellar, so hopefully we can keep that up. Very cool truck. We'll be right back. All right, back where we started. So we'd be here around 5:45. It's 5:48. Pretty good estimation. Hopefully we can get in and out of here quick and be done for the day. Checked in. All right.